And this morning, we're getting a rare behind-the-scenes look at NASA's largest and most powerful space telescope.
The James Webb Space Telescope is being built right now, and project manager Bill Oakes joins us live from NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, with more. And Bill, at least when I think about space telescopes, I always think about Hubble. So how is this one different?
So this is, we're to the next of the great observatories that NASA's building, but we have two real big differences between us and Hubble. One, we are a lot bigger than Hubble. Our primary mirror is about 7 times the size of Hubble's. We're about 3 stories high, about the size of a tennis court. We're also an infrared telescope versus Hubble, which is a visible light telescope. Those differences allow us to go back and look at some of the very first stars and galaxies that were formed after the Big Bang.
So when this launches, it's going to be miles and miles away. How do you know it's doing what it's supposed to be doing?
So what we do, as any NASA program, whether you're a million miles away like us or whether you're in low Earth orbit, the key to any program is a rigorous test program, and that's what we do here both at Goddard and at some of our other centers around the other contractors and partners around the country. Right now we're in the process of testing the telescope out after putting it through environmental testing, which simulated the environment that it sees in the launch vehicle.
And why the name James Webb? Who's this named for?
It's named for the administrator for NASA, who really made the commitment to go to the moon, but also recognized the importance of science to NASA and doing satellites like James Webb.
It's got to be quite an honor for him, for sure, and its family. But Webb is the largest space telescope ever built. It's about 3 stories tall. So how do you build a telescope that big and test it on Earth, but then know what it's going to do when it encounters a completely different environment?
So we start out testing at the smallest components and work our way up. And like I said, what we're doing here at Goddard right now is we're testing the telescope, which is integrated with our instruments, our 4 scientific instruments. When we complete that here, we go down to Texas, we do some testing there. And then we eventually go out to California, where it meets up with the rest of the observatory for its final assembly and test before we go to our launch site.
Well, I'll tell you, I'm always in awe when we see, you know, these close-up images from space. I cannot wait to see what the Webb is going to be sending back our way. So really exciting stuff there. Thank you so much for sharing that with us this morning.
Thanks for waking up early
to
join us. Have a great day. Thanks so much.